This video explains the signs and treatment of low blood sugar. Low blood sugar is when the blood sugar level goes too far below your child's target range. The medical term for low blood sugar is hypoglycemia. For most kids, anything less than 80 in the daytime is considered low blood sugar. But it does depend on your child's age, so check with your diabetes team. We need enough sugar in the blood to fuel the body at all times. If our blood sugar level drops too low, the body can run out of energy quickly. A low blood sugar that is not treated can lead to seizure, loss of consciousness, coma, or death. Everyone who cares for your child must know how to find and treat a low blood sugar. Here is what to look for. If your child is shaking, sweating, confused, hungry, experiencing headaches, or getting very tired or sleepy, these are all signs that your child may have low blood sugar. There are other symptoms of low blood sugar too. Not everyone has the same symptoms, and some people do not have any symptoms. For a full list of signs and symptoms, please check the handbook. Treating low blood sugar. We treat low blood sugar levels with 15 grams of quick sugar. Do not give insulin when trying to raise blood sugar. You should always carry a quick sugar with you. Here are examples of some quick sugars. 3 to 4 glucose tabs, a half cup of juice or 4 ounces, 6 jelly beans, 1 tablespoon of sugar, a half tube of glucose gel. Foods with a lot of protein, fat, or fiber slow down sugar entering the bloodstream. Do not use these to treat a low blood sugar quickly. When treating low blood sugar, use the rule of 15. We use the rule of 15 to get the blood sugar back into the target range without it going too high. First, give 15 grams of quick sugar without insulin. Wait 15 minutes, and then check the blood sugar to see if it worked. Then, if the blood sugar is still too low, give 15 more grams of quick sugar, wait another 15 minutes, then check the blood sugar again. At this point, if blood sugar level is still not within the target range, call the clinic or the on-call doctor. But if you check the blood sugar and it is in the target range, you do not need to give any more quick sugar. And even though the blood sugar is back in the target range, you will now want to check it frequently for the next 24 hours to make sure the blood sugar doesn't go low again. In some rare cases, you might need to use glucagon for a low blood sugar. The body uses the hormone called glucagon to tell the liver to release sugar into the blood. This is how glucagon can raise blood sugar levels without having to use food. Glucagon is only for emergencies. For example, if it is unsafe for your child to swallow a quick sugar, or if your child passes out or has a seizure from low blood sugar. A glucagon kit for people with diabetes is similar to an EpiPen for people who have severe allergies. It is very rarely used, but it can be life-saving in an emergency. Keep a glucagon kit with you at all times. There are two things inside the case. One, a special syringe that contains a liquid, and two, a vial that contains a powder of glucagon. If you do need to use glucagon, follow these steps. Step 1. First, send someone to call 911 if possible. If no one is able to call, first give the glucagon and then call 911. Step 2. Turn your child onto the side so he or she doesn't choke on vomit. Step 3. Inject all the liquid from the syringe into the vial of powder. Step 4. Swirl or shake the bottle well. Step 5. Draw up the right dose as directed. Step 6. Give the glucagon injection into a big muscle, like the top of the thigh or the buttock. Step 7. Check the blood sugar level in 15 minutes. For more information on glucagon and low blood sugar, talk to your diabetes team.